spreading the word to the people who needed to hear. Oh, I readily did accept Muhammad's message from God. Abu Bakr As-Siddiq, the Prophet's faithful friend, trusted and protected him, his love had no end. Abu Bakr As-Siddiq, Allah be pleased with him, companion in Jannah, oh blessed by Allah, Abu Bakr As-Siddiq.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Second of the two, Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. What an honor to talk about this companion, the beloved companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The man whom, if you place in one side of the scale and the rest of the ummah in the other side of the scale, he will outweigh all the ummah. And this is not my statement. This is the statement of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu. And it is fi Musnad al-Imam. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu said, لو وزن إيمان أبي بكر بإيمان الأمة لرجح إيمان أبي بكر. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a lot of speakers, scholars who speak about the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are so negligent of this companion, and it is time, maybe in this series, that we talk about Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu sufficiently. Intentionally, or to begin with, I have decided not to go into the biography of the companions, rather to talk about some of the events. But I decided to stress on Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu because of his nearness to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Add to this the negligence that a lot of the speakers, a lot of the khutaba, those who speak in Jum'ah, they hardly speak about him. They always talk about Umar, they always talk about the rest of the companions, but very few they will talk about Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. And you know why? Because Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu was always next to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So you would have to focus on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But brothers and sisters in Islam, يَأْبَى اللَّهُ, Allah refuses, وَالْمُسْلِمُونَ, and the Muslims, that anyone takes precedence ahead of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. Not even Ali ibn Abi Talib. Not even Ali ibn Abi Talib. Listen to this hadith. And the hadith fi Sahih al-Bukhari. And the narrator of this hadith is Muhammad ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib. Muhammad, the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib. And I'm intentionally bringing this hadith, and I know some people would understand what I'm saying. Muhammad, he is the son of ibn al-Hanafiyya. That's his kunya. That is how he is known. He asked his father one day, Ya Abati, my father, Ya Abi, Man khayrun nasi ba'da Rasulillah? Who is the best of people after the messenger of Allah? You know what Ali ibn Abi Talib said? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Then he asked, then who? He said, Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anhu. Muhammad, the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib, said, and I became afraid to ask him, then who? Then he would say, Uthman ibn Affan. So I decided to ask him, then you, my father. He said, Ya Bunay, my son, Ma ana illa ahadun rajulun min al Muslimin. I'm just a man from the Muslims. Ya Allah, that generation, brothers and sisters in Islam. I'm just a Muslim. I'm trying to make it. Don't even give me any preference. This is Ali ibn Abi Talib, radiallahu anhu. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it was narrated. Fi Musnad al-Imam. Good chain of narration. As a matter of fact, Ahmad Shakir, rahimahullah, authenticated that chain of narration and he said it's sahih. That Ali ibn Abi Talib in al-Kufa, in Iraq, more than one time, more than two times, more than three times, always he would say, خَيْرُ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ بَعْدَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أَبُو بَكْرِ وَعُمَرُ بْنِ الْخَطَّابِ. The best of this ummah after the Messenger of Allah is Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and Umar ibn al-Khattab. Brothers and sisters in Islam, في معجم الطبراني, Ali ibn Abi Talib himself said, Ali ibn Abi Talib himself said, خَيْرُ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ, the best of this ummah after Rasulullah, ba'da Rasulullah, after the Messenger of Allah, is Abu Bakr al-Siddiq wa Umar ibn al-Khattab. Is Abu Bakr al-Siddiq and Umar ibn al-Khattab. وَلَا يَجْتَمِعُ حُبِّي وَبُغْضُهُمْ فِي قَلْبِ مُؤْمِنٍ. And my love, if you claim that you love Ali ibn Abi Talib and at the same time you hate Abu Bakr and Umar, those two feelings cannot stay together in a heart of a believer. In a heart of a believer. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Umar cannot even take precedence ahead of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Ya'ballah, Allah refuses, and the Muslims refuses. And this is the statement, this is the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. An Abdullah ibn Zama'ah, radiyallahu anhu. And the hadith fil musnad, fi sunan al-Tirmidhi. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became his ill, his final illness, and towards the beginning of it, Abdullah ibn Zama'ah was sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Bilal called the adhan, and then he came to ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to come and lead the salah. Of course, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very sick, was already very sick, and he could not leave bed. And he told Bilal, ask one of the companions to head you, to lead you in the salah. Bilal went outside. Abu Bakr was absent. Abu Bakr was not there, but he saw Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiyallahu anh, and he asked Umar to lead the salah. Of course, Umar had a very loud voice. He would say, Allahu Akbar. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard his takbir in his bed, and he said, where is Abu Bakr? Where is Abu Bakr? Where is Abu Bakr? Ya'ballah, Allah refuses and the Muslims refuses that anyone takes precedence ahead of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. وفي البخاري ومسلم من حديث عائشة رضي الله عنها. Of course, this hadith that I just quoted was at the beginning of his sickness. Later on, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would actually name Abu Bakr. When the time for the salah is here and the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would already know that Abu Bakr al-Siddiq cannot come to lead the salah, he would say literally to Aisha or to Hafsa, Muru Aba Bakr falyusalli bin nas. Command Abu Bakr to lead the salah. At one occasion, at one time, Aisha said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulallah, O Messenger of Allah, Inna Aba Bakr rajulun asif. Abu Bakr is very soft in heart. And when he recites the Quran, he weeps and he cries. And the companions would not be able to hear his recitation. And at one time, Aisha radiallahu anha, this is the daughter of Abu Bakr radiallahu anha, she asked Hafsa to ask the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to allow Umar to lead the salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam repeated the statement, Muru Aba Bakr falyusalli bin nas. Ask Abu Bakr to lead the salah. When Hafsa asked him again, he said, La antunna sawahibu Yusuf. You are the companions of Yusuf. He's referring to the women and their fitna with Yusuf. Of course, this is a very angry tone expressing the fact that no one shall take any precedence ahead of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq in this ummah. brothers and sisters in Islam, I have never seen a relationship between two individuals that is filled with love as I have seen that relationship between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Abi Bakr as-Siddiq. Ya Allah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam expressed this in words and in action. In words and in action. He always would hang around Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, as Aisha narrated, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam would always come and visit us in the morning and at night. When Amr ibn al-As radiyallahu anhu, and the hadith fi Sahih al-Bukhari, asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Ya Rasul Allah, O Messenger of Allah, man ahabbu an-nasi ilayk? Who is the person that you love most? Qala Aisha. He said, Aisha. Listen, 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 my brothers and sisters in Islam. There are people who go after the mother of the believers. Hear what your messenger said. The beloved to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, stay away from her. She is your mother. She is your mother. Stay away from her. He said, Aisha radiallahu anha. Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anha said, O Messenger of Allah, from the men, min al-rijal, qala abuha. He said, her father, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Then who, O Messenger of Allah? Then Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam actually expressed this love that he had for Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu in a situation that is so unique. And the one who was part of that situation was Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Just to let you know that how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam had that love for Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, because Abu Bakr as-Siddiq was the one who comforted the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wal hadith rawahu ibn Ishaq, yani fi sanadihi kalam, in its chain of narration there is some narrators who are weak, but it has supporting evidence from a hadith that is quoted by Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma fi hilyat al-awliya al-fadl ibn Dukaym. The overall meanings of the two statements that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, when I came to people telling them that I am the messenger of Allah, I'm inviting you to Islam, none of them, but he asked why. He had a kabwa. He was hesitant. Except Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. I came to him and I told him, I am the messenger of Allah, Abu Bakr. Believe. Say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. He did not ask one question. He said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. Let's take a short break and come back talking about Abi Bakr as-Siddiq, second of the two, ثاني اثنين, رضي الله عنه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
I rarely did accept Muhammad's message from God.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose whom he wills subhanahu wa ta'ala for his mercy, for his messengership, for the revelation to be revealed. This is not for the human beings to make that decision. If a person would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely, truthfully, asking for forgiveness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised to forgive. We have as Muslims a duty, and that is to recite the book of Allah, to ponder over the verses, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to act according to the Quran. The mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything, but it who would this mercy will be for? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent to all mankind. So the ummah, or the people of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, are all mankind since the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam till the day of judgment. Why waste our life without getting to know every verse in the Quran, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us?
Message from God, Muhammad.
Brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to Righteous Companions. Before the break, I mentioned that there was that amount of love that is, you cannot even talk about it. You have to experience it. I have never seen two individuals, two brothers, two individuals loving one another so much like Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And like I mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam expressed this in words. Once he was asked about the most beloved by Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu, as is mentioned in Sahih al-Bukhari, the most beloved to you, O Messenger of Allah, from the men, he said Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And he actually expressed this in action. And listen to this. The hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, hadith Abi Darda radiallahu anhu. Abi Darda mentioned that there was a debate or some argument between Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. Abu Bakr kind of overdid it with Umar. And he retreated. He wanted to basically apologize to Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu for what he said. Umar refused his apology. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu became upset and he decided to go to the comfort zone where he finds his comfort with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he approached the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was sitting with the rest of the companions. And he was lifting his garment in his hand. And you can tell that he's unhappy. There is something wrong. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is his friend, he knows there is something wrong in his face. He looked at his companions and he said, أَمَّا صَاحِبُكُمْ فَقَدْ غَامَرْ. I can tell there is something wrong with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. When Abu Bakr as-Siddiq approached the gathering, radiyallahu anhu, he said, Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, what is wrong, Abu Bakr? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, I did something wrong to Umar. And I wanted to apologize to him, but he would not accept my apology. And I feel bad about it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this, يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَكَ يَا أَبَا بَكْرِ يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَكَ يَا أَبَا بَكْرِ يَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَكَ يَا أَبَا بَكْرِ May Allah forgive you, Abu Bakr, three times. After a while, Umar already felt that he made a mistake not to accept the apology of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. So he immediately went to the house of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, asking where he is so he can make up with him. Where is Abu Bakr? He asked Abu Bakr's family. They said he is not here. He already knew if he is not in his house, he must be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So he looked for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and he went there. When the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw Umar radiallahu an approaching the crowd, tama'ara wajhu an-nabi. He became so angry. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq immediately felt that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam will speak in an angry tone to Umar ibn al-Khattab and he may say something that is not maybe good for Umar to be said to him. And he stood up and he placed his knees in the ground and he said, Ya Rasulallah, O Messenger of Allah, Wallahi inni kuntu adlam, by Allah, I am the one who wronged him. Please forgive him, O Messenger of Allah. By Allah, I was the one who wronged Umar. Basically trying to get the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to come down. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was angry for his beloved friend Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. Then the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looked at his companions when they were sitting, and including Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, and he said, Ayyuhan nas, O mankind, O people, laqad ji'tukum, I came to you with Islam. And they said, you lied. And others, they said, no, I'm not going to accept it. And others were hesitant. And when I came to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, they said, sadaqt. He said, you spoke the truth. I'm going to believe in what you believe in. And I'm going to give you all what I have. I'm going to give you all my family, all my wealth, everything that I have for this deen, brothers and sisters in Islam. Even Abu Bakr expressed that love. He expressed that love to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in more than one occasion. When the disbelievers one day were harming the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he rushed to the Kaaba, rescuing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, calling them, "Are you killing someone who is saying La ilaha illallah? Ataqtuluna rajulan yaqul Rabbi Allah?" And the event of the Hijrah, brothers and sisters in Islam, fi Sunan al-Bayhaqi, and we know that it has some authenticity issues in it, but I'm going to quote to you an athar hadith fi Sahih al-Bukhari an al-Bara ibn Azib radiyallahu anhu. Abu Bakr al-Siddiq is the narrator of this hadith. He said, after the duration of time that they spent in the cave in their way to Medina, migrating and fleeing from the disbelievers in Mecca. We know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam hid in a cave, Thawr, for almost 3 nights. So they are in their way to Medina, and they were walking in the desert. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu said, it was so hot, فَقَامَ قَائِمُ الظَّهِيرَةِ. It is extremely hot, and those who went to Mecca and did Hajj would know what I'm talking about. There is no shade. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq went around the desert looking for shade, trying to find shade for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to be shaded under, until he found a rock and still had some shade underneath it. He went and he brought a mat or a garment and he placed it under this rock, and he said, "Idhaja ya Rasul Allah, sleep, O Messenger of Allah. You're tired and it's so hot. Get a break, O Messenger of Allah." Abu Bakr as-Siddiq is also experiencing the same hardship, but here he is caring about his companion, caring about his friend. Actually, at the beginning of this hadith, he said this: I used to walk in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then I go back and I walk behind him because I'm afraid someone is going to come and harm him from the front of him, and I was afraid that someone is going to come and harm him from the back of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at the amount of care that he had for Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then I saw a shepherd coming down with his flocks, and I asked him to give us some milk. So we milked one of the sheep, and I made sure that it's placed in a container where it will make the milk a little bit cold for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to drink. Look what Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu said: "Ishrab ya Rasul Allah, drink, O Messenger of Allah." Fashariba hatta radit. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept drinking milk until I became satisfied that he had enough. Ya Allah. Or that incident, you know, after the conquest of Mecca, the father of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Abi Quhafa radiyallahu anhu, was not a Muslim yet. Yani he's one of the last of the family members of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq who became a Muslim, the father of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu. And he was in Mecca. And when the messenger came and conquered Mecca with the Muslims, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq were sitting down, and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq brought his very old father. He had a beard so white, very old father, so that he would basically become a Muslim in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he would say, "Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah." When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam saw the father of Abi Bakr, he told his friend, "Why, Abu Bakr, you brought the old man? We should have gone to him." And then when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is hearing the shahada from the father of Abi Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu made a statement, "Wallahi, out of this world." Qala ya Rasul Allah, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, I wish this is your uncle. I wish this is your uncle Abu Talib. Ya Allah. We know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he wanted his uncle to be a Muslim so bad, and he became so distressed once his uncle died as a mushrik, as a kafir, to the extent that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to him Jibreel with the verse in Surah Al-Qasas, "Innaka la tahdi man ahbabt, walakinna Allah yahdi man yasha." You do not guide whom you will, but Allah guides whom he wills. So Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu knowing the amount of love that he had for his uncle, he is wishing that his father would be the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in order to make his friend happy. Can you find a friendship? Can you find love between two individuals than Abi Bakr as-Siddiq and Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? ثاني اثنين إدهما في الغار. ثاني اثنين إدهما في الغار. Second of the two. Brothers and sisters in Islam, like I mentioned, I have decided to talk in details, in more details, about Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, different to the rest of the companions. I will not go through the biography, but I will talk a little bit more, especially about Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, because he has not got his right yet from the Ummah. Therefore, we will talk about him maybe the next episode and the next episode as well, maybe two more episodes about Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Please join us to learn more about Abu Bakr as-Siddiq in the series Righteous Companions. Till then, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Companions spread in the world to the people who needed to hear. How readily did he accept Muhammad's message from God? Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, the Prophet's faithful friend, trusted and protected him. His love had no end. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, Allah be pleased with him, companion in Jannah, oh blessed by Allah. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, the Prophet's faithful friend.